Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, we're going to look at one of the list properties. It's the expiry property. And this is most commonly used if you have a list of people. You might want to track when their competencies or licenses expire. Or if you've got a list of plant or vehicles or assets, you might want to track when servicing is due. This is really easy to do in Dashpivot and quite powerful because you can set it up so that it will automatically remind you when that servicing or that renewal is due. So we're going to cover that in this video. You can see here we're in the list section. We've got our list of employees here. You can see a bunch of names. We want to add a new property here. And in this example, we're going to call it our license expiry. And we're going to make sure that the property that we select is this one here, this date expiry property. Select that, click add. What it's going to do is add a new column. And for each row, you can see we can now select a date. So presuming that we know when everyone's licenses expire, we can start to punch in that information into this register. Now you notice that depending on the date that we select, Dashpivot will automatically color code them. So if the license expiry or the date that's selected is more than 7 days away, it'll come up in green. If it's less than 7 days, it'll come up in yellow. And if it's actually, if that date has passed, it'll come up in red. So this is super useful when you've got a long list of assets or people and you want to quickly scan and see anything that's upcoming. That's the first thing that you want to do So Dashpivot helps. So Dashpivot makes it really easy to track this information visually. And the second thing that you'll want to do is once you've entered in all of these dates is configure any notifications that you'd like to be sent out as these dates approach or once they have passed. So we have a few options in Dashpivot. What we can do is we can click this eyeball icon. And you see here that we can select someone to get notified. So in this case, maybe we want to notify Anne. And then we can actually choose when we want to notify Anne in relation to this date here. So maybe we send a notification 30 days before we reach that date, 7 days before, and then maybe once it's overdue. You can select any combination of all of these, and Dashpivot will automatically send out an email once you're 30 days out or 7 days out or overdue. Any of these options here, there will be an automatic email that goes out. Click update and just save that into Dashpivot. And yeah, that's the nuts and bolts of how it works. Feel free to check out our other videos and tutorials in the tutorials section via the Dashpivot website. But if you get stuck or have a specific question, you can always reach us via the live chat on the Dashpivot website and also in the Dashpivot mobile app. I hope this has been useful and thanks for watching.